What is up, guys? Welcome to Dragonball 24/7 podcast. I'm your host, Jesse Goku. And normally we would be talking about the episode of Dragon Ball Super, episode number 40. But we're not going to really get into too much detail about that episode. There are plenty of other podcasters to talk all things Dragon Ball that have reviewed the episode, given their thoughts, their theories, speculations, and everything in between. Now, I will talk about it a little bit, but we're not going to get into too much detail because I'm actually more interested to learn about the new episode. And once the next episode comes out next week, episode 41, I will go into detail about what I think and my speculations. But until then, there are other things that I want to talk about as far as Dragon Ball goes. Before we continue, I would like to thank all of my supporters for supporting this channel. We have gotten even more subscribers and more views lately, and I'm very happy. Thank you, everyone. The next episode of Dragon Ball 24/7 podcast, we'll be talking about Goku versus Superman, and I will go into really big details about my opinion on the subject. That is one of the biggest fights in all of geekdom, fandom, nerddom, anime, comic book. I mean, when it comes to what if battle scenarios, Goku and Superman is one of the most request battles, whether it be superpower beatdown, death battle, animation rewind, epic rap battles of history, or anything, 1 minute melee, doesn't matter what it is, people will request Superman versus Goku. And I actually want to talk about that a little, but we're going to talk about the next episode. This episode, we're going to talk about the Zulu, the Omni King, the overseer of the 12 universes. He stands at the pinnacle of the 12 universes. Now, who is this character? Is he a god? Is he a new god? The way Ciampa and Beerus reacted to his presence in the ring indicates that he is a higher tier than that of the gods of destruction and Whis and Varus. Now, we don't know exactly too much about this character. We just know that they are going to play a major role in the next couple episodes. This character, when we got the episode titles and descriptions, it was saying that Ciampa was going to attack his team, but then someone steps forward. We thought it might have been the new villain. We thought it might have been Future Trunks or anybody. But it's this character. This character is called the Omni King. Pretty much ruler of everything. Are they like a Kai? Are they a god? Are they like the sentinel being? When it comes to this universe, are they considered the god? The little guy is pretty much the most powerful character as of right now that we know. Well, we don't actually know if he's a fighter. We don't know how powerful he is. But I'm going based on Beerus' reaction, because Beerus reacted the same way Shenron reacted when he heard that Beerus was on Earth. So there are so many questions and not enough answers. And this is why it's so exciting to be a Dragon Ball fan right now, because there are so many things going on with Dragon Ball. They're adding so much lore and they're expanding. It's no longer one universe anymore. There's 12. It's a multiverse, and pretty maybe eventually down the line we'll get more and more storylines, and I hope they introduce more characters as well, like the Saiyans from Universe 6. I would love to see Goku and Vegeta go and meet the other Saiyans. Also, is Akira Toriyama going to do anything with the Super Saiyan White? Is he actually going to bring that forth in the series? Maybe Goku can get white Super Saiyan hair as another transformation later on in the series and become like a Super Saiyan Cosmic or something. And I predicted there would be a white Super Saiyan, or I speculated. Before we even made this podcast, I was telling a lot of my friends, you know, maybe there should have been a Super Saiyan White, maybe, because it kind of follows the base of a flame. You have yellow, red, blue, and the hottest being white. And that's kind of what it follows. I don't know if that's intentional or not, but I assumed we'd be getting a Super Saiyan White. And sure enough, Akira Toriyama revealed in an interview that originally Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan was going to be white, but it clashed with one of the future antagonists of the series. So I'm excited to see where this series goes. You know, up until now, Dragon Ball Super has been a little slow to start because they had to do a retelling of the movies. And I understand completely why they had to do that. And I'm going to cover that later on this episode, though. We're going to talk about Dragon Ball Z Funko Pop, the second line that's coming out. Now, here are a picture of the new Funkos that are coming out for Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z. You have Kid Goku. You have Gohan. You have Future Trunks. You have Majin Buu. Bulma. And you have the final one, which is Krillin. Now, these are really cool. And I'm a collector of Funko. I have the Dragon Ball Z ones as well. I don't have the Comic-Con exclusive PA Vegeta, which is the planet Ariel, the Comic-Con exclusive that's worth almost $400. I don't have that one, and I also don't have the metallic painted Vegeta as well, or Golden Frieza with the red eyes. I have Golden Frieza, which was a Comic-Con exclusive, but with the black eyes and not the red eyes. Now, these Funko Pops are coming out in July, I believe. You can reserve them right now at Amazon. And you can also sign up for Amazon Prime, which offers free two-day shipping. When you reserve them with Amazon, you actually don't pay until they ship them out to you. I know this because I do reserve a lot of items that are really pricey, and they don't actually charge me until they've shipped out the item, which is really good because now I can save up for these. There are six new Funkos that we know of that are coming out. That's not including exclusives that they may do down the road. And hopefully they do a Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan Goku. And the reason why they would call him Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan Goku instead of Super Saiyan Blue, because in the United States, where they would more than likely make the Funko, he is still known as a Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan, because we have not yet localized Dragon Ball Super. Despite the fact that in Asia, Dragon Ball Super is getting a English dub of the anime through the Asian Regional Cartoon Network, that is not coming to the United States, because in the United States, Funimation handles all the dubbing and distributing for Dragon Ball Z, not Toy directly, because they've licensed it to Funimation, and Funimation handles all that. Even Funimation handles all the dubbing for the video games with Bandai, and Bandai, you know, handles everything when it comes to merchandising, whether it be figures or wall scrolls or video games or posters or anything. It's officially licensed. Even with the Funkos, they have to have the Bandai, you know, logo, as well as the Funimation. But I'm very excited to get these Funkos. They're really cool. And if you haven't collected Funkos before, they're chibi figures. Here's another look at them. They're about 4 inches. They're really fun to collect. You kind of want to keep them in the box to retain their value. But as far as a Dragon Ball Z collector goes, I do collect a lot of these figures. And sometimes, even if you're not a major collector, let's say you collect some Dragon Ball Z stuff, these would be a really good part of your collection, considering the fact that some of them are actually really hard to find, like the normal black hair Goku, which was a Hot Topic exclusive, is worth like $43 right now, according to popriceguide.com. He's become a rare Funko, and his value actually goes up. Really, it went from $39 to $43 in a matter of a few weeks, and it's only a matter of time before that Funko is actually worth like $100. It made me go up because the Vegeta, the Comic-Con exclusive Vegeta one, is worth $400 or $300, and you know, there's not a lot of people that are willing to pay that much. And that was a Toy Tokyo, I think. It was an exclusive for one of the conventions here in the United States. It was a very big convention on the scale of New York City Comic Con, in which a lot of people know that New York City Comic Con is the Comic Con a lot of us go to when it comes to toys. Like, collectibles, figures, Transformers, Power Rangers, all that good stuff, because a lot of that stuff is revealed at New York City Comic Con, or at least we get some kind of hint or info or indication that we are going to get something new. And Dragon Ball Z also gets a lot of stuff exclusively released just for New York City Comic Con. When it comes to figures, and like I said, if you're a collector of the figures, and not just the figures, I mean, Dragon Ball in general, I do recommend that these you get these Funkos. And please don't be a scalper. Don't be one of the people that buy like five of them and then turn around and sell them for three times the price. You know, that's not cool. That's, as a fan, we all want to enjoy this together. And we're all in this together. But I am also doing custom Funkos. I'm starting to learn. I am going to be doing, hopefully, a Super Saiyan Blue Goku and a Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta. I am currently learning how to work with clay, and I'm buying the do-it-yourself Funko. Honestly, there's a lot of customs right now. You can probably go on eBay and find a lot of custom, you know, Super Saiyan 4 Goku, Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta, Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, you know, Gohan. There's a lot of them. So, you know, there's no real way to stop collecting Funko. And I think Funko was really smart when they included Dragon Ball Z, because Dragon Ball Z was, I think, if the first anime license that they got to do the characters for, and eventually they got Attack on Titan and Tokyo Ghoul and Black Butler, and now they got Naruto and Bleach and One Piece. Now they're getting all these other anime, and Dragon Ball Z is already getting their second wave of characters, where all these other animes have just barely gotten their first. So that's really good. And Dragon Ball Z is so impactful when it comes to pop culture. I mean, when Battle of Gods came out in Japan, it was the first Japanese film to be made in the IMAX format. You should definitely look that up. It is true. And when Resurrection F came out in Japan, the same weekend Furious 7 came out, and that was the last Fast and the Furious movie with Paul Walker. Unfortunately, Paul Walker had died the year before in a terrible car accident. Rest his soul. Dragon Ball Resurrection F actually beat Furious 7 in the box office the opening weekend. See, that's amazing right there. I mean, Dragon Ball has come so far. It's embedded into the fabric of pop culture. It's never going to go away. It's more than the Dragon Ball anime started in 1986 and the Dragon Ball manga started in 1984. It's more than 30 years old, and it shows no indication of going away anytime soon. Even when the anime ended, it still stayed alive because the fans wanted it to continue. And lots of anime, believe it or not, you know, die once they end. I mean, look at Death Note. Death Note kind of withered away once it ended. Yeah, they're getting new movies, but that's because the popularity of it is starting to pick up again. But overall, it kind of just went away. So with that, we're going to bring this video to a close. Please like and subscribe our video. Check out Geekdom 101. There's a link below. And stay classy, everyone.